So this is Troll. Once upon a time, in a city of mist and light, a wide silver river curled its way like a stretching cat between spires of stone and shards of glass and the odd narcissistic palace. By day, the sun glinted on its beauty like diamonds. By night, its lights glowed ruby red like a million magic lanterns. Its people buzzed like spring brick bees through its streets and alleys, busy and purposeful, making honey, making money. And over this wide silver river, bridges arched and soared, shining, spanning sisters, reaching out to grasp each bank. These shining, spanning sisters each had names graced upon them by the city bigwigs, who spun their webs and ate their fine dinners between the streets and buildings. Blackfriars, Tower, Lambeth, Waterloo. Waterloo, ah, Waterloo. Let me tell you about Waterloo. Waterloo was a plainer bridge than some, and cursed with a mischievous headwind, even on a still summer day, and curiously, always in whichever direction you crossed. Even if you spun in the middle of the span, it spun with you. Waterloo Bridge had few other things to distinguish it. No towers, no soaring cabled superstructure that lit up the night like a string of fairy lights, no Big Ben on one side and Boudicca on the other. But it did have one thing. It had a troll. Wait, I know what you're thinking. Large, greeny brown, evil smelling, knobbly, aggressive, bad teeth, even worse breath, and an attitude problem. That sort of troll. And indeed, some of that is true. But this is, of course, the 21st century. The trolls we have are just as evil as in the days when magic bubbled along our cobbled streets. But our trolls are also very much human. For this, my friend, was a Twitter troll. And there on Waterloo Bridge, he lolled and lolled. Man spread against the stone balustrade like a gargoyle. He tweeted photos of those who passed, with some biting, cutting, scratching comment designed to scythe its way through a person's soul. Stranger shaming, a casual cruelty, the worst kind of cruelty. And so we see him mock the wayward hair of a woman who skitters past. Her child died on Monday, and she hasn't slept for days as her mind tries desperately to calibrate what is in truth an immeasurable grief. She walks as if she's been punctured through the heart, which indeed she has. She needs only human kindness. She finds none here. And our troll mocks the eccentric hotchpotch, mismatched clothes of a loner who hurts no one except himself. A gentle, fragile soul adrift in a sea of bitter sharpness. He needs only human kindness. He finds none here. And our troll mocks the stuttering, uneducated speech of a boy who's missing school to care for his mother and younger siblings as he tries to clasp his family together and stop it breaking loose and scattering in the breeze like down from a dandelion clock. He too only needs human kindness. He too finds none here. Some people think this bants, and our troll's Twitter following grows. And as it grows, so does the twisted blackness in his heart. And so does the twisted blackness in his followers' hearts. I've got a wasp. He measures out his life's worth in followers. And so people start to avoid the bridge. They zigzag by other paths. The babbling flow becomes a trickle. Waterloo Bridge becomes grey-shaded and unloved. It stiffens. It grows tired. It loses hope. But there is always hope. There is always hope. One spring Friday, the crepuscular rays of evening are turning the river gold and burnt orange. The air still grips the chill memory of winter. The odd rat scuttles along the gutter, sniffing, making sure it is always within a metre of a human. From the deep chocolate shadows, three Essex sisters trip-trap towards the bridge, their shadows stretching like black silk opera gloves. The rat turns and sniffs the air expectantly. The sisters stop in a pool of light that oozes from the street lamps like warm jam. The youngest holds up a hand with diamante stars embedded immaculately in each nail. She tilts her head and points at the south bank, which is glowing and winking with promise, a sparkling stellar meringue. "We want to go there," she says, and she takes a single brittle step forward. But quickly the second sister steps close behind her, her breath involuntarily held, and rests a protective hand upon her shoulder. "But what about the troll?" she whispers, fear making her voice small. "What about the troll?" And both sisters look with dread towards the span of Waterloo Bridge stretching out before them. Then the eldest sister steps close behind them both and lays a strong hand on each sister's shoulder and says in a voice as firm as lichened rock, "Do not be afraid of the troll." The three sisters turn to each other and fold and gather themselves around as tight as a woven willow basket, and they whisper a plan as so many of London's secrets are whispered. And after clenched minutes, they unfurl like spring leaves and stand and stretch, the lights reflecting brightly in their faces. The youngest tosses her auburn hair and slicks a fresh lick of hot pink lipstick across her mouth. "I ain't scared of no troll," she says, and off she sets across the bridge. Trip, trap, trip, trap, her footsteps ringing out across the deserted bridge until she reaches the middle. And the troll slouches up from the parapet where he had been leaning and strolls his lazy troll-like stroll, rolling like a tar barrel where the tar has hardened off-center. He stands astride the path, hitches up his jeans, and blocks the youngest sister's way. Right, you ready? "Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?" he roars, eyes popping and arms stretched out wide. "It's me," says the youngest sister, cooler than a forest floor on an autumn morning. "Who's asking?" The troll snorts. He steps closer, and even the bricks in the bridge try to shrink from him. "I'm going to troll you up," he says, and he takes out his smartphone and presses the phone app with a trolley thumb. "Oh no," says the youngest sister, arms crossed and gaze steady. "You don't want to do that. You want to wait for my sister. She's much more of a slapper than me. Don't waste your time trolling me." The troll wrinkles his nose. He sniffs. He contemplates this information. There is a pause. A tug noses its way beneath the bridge. The troll considers. He speaks. "Well then," he says, "I've not got much battery left, to be honest. Be off with you. I'll wait for your sister." And he steps to one side, leering. The youngest sister rolls her eyes and trip-traps across the bridge, down the South Bank steps and into a cocktail bar. There she slides smoothly onto a shiny circular stool and orders three margaritas. "Bring it on," she whispers to the expectant air. The mischievous wind shifts. Back on the far side of the bridge, the second sister squirts a squirt of scent, channels Beyoncé and sets off over the bridge. Trip, trap, trip, trap, towards the middle of the span. And the troll strolls his trolley out of kilter stroll to block her path. Ready?
Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?
Better? He roars a second time. It is I, the second sister says, as calm as a hill in midnight moonlight. She pauses and tilts her head to one side, appraising him. Are you scratching your groin? No, says the troll, taken aback at her bluntness. I was merely rearranging my bits. He removes his hand from his trousers and sniffs it. Anyway, I'm gonna troll you up, he says. And he takes out his smartphone and presses his photo app with a trolley thumb. Oh no, says the second sister. You don't want to do that. You want to wait for my eldest sister. You ain't seen a face that twisted. That's what you want. You want to troll her. The troll frowns. He considers. He looks at the thin green sliver on his battery indicator. He speaks. Okay, he says. Be off with you. I'll wait for your sister. And he slides his phone back into his pocket and narrows his trolley eyes. And the second sister traps across the bridge and down the South Bank steps. And she too slides smoothly onto a silver circular stool, raising the waiting margarita and clinks it with her sister. Back on the north side of the bridge, the eldest sister tilts her hat to battle position. Bring it on, motherfucker, she whispers, and the mischievous wind turns and blows gently behind her. Trip, trap, trip, trap, ricochet her footsteps on the bridge. For the eldest sister is wearing steel toe and heel tipped 20-hole purple Doc Martens. Trip, trap, to the middle of the bridge. And the troll strolls his trolley stroll and blocks her path.
Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?
He roars, sliding his phone out of his pocket and opening it up. It is I, says the eldest sister. She steps forward and looks him up and down. He grins a leery grin. She grins a wider grin. His grin falters, for there in her eyes is a resolution that cracks him like a teaspoon through an eggshell. In one smooth motion, she stamps hard on his trolley foot and snatches his phone. As he howls in pain, clutching his tootsies, she opens his photo stream. She scrolls quickly through until she finds that secret, shameful selfie that he never, ever intended anyone to see, ever. She selects it and tweets it to his 700,000 trolley followers. She pauses briefly to watch the retweet stack up, turns the screen so he can see what she's done. Then she takes a single step back and drop kicks the phone over the parapet and into the magical river below, in a perfect arc. The troll howls with rage and horror. Trip, trap, trip, trap, ricochet the eldest sister's footsteps across the bridge and down the steps. And soon she too is sipping a margarita on the South Bank. The laughter of the three sisters tinkles like breaking icicles. The wind changes. Waterloo Bridge blushes red in the sunset. The grey leaches from it like a tide going out. A group of colourful chattering tourists meanders across like a flock of parakeets. A single rat tracks them carefully along the gutter. And through the rhythm and roll of the skateboarders, you can just hear the howling of a very ex-troll. And the three sisters, well, they live happily ever after, of course. And the troll? Well, he had met his Waterloo. And her name? Ah, yes, her name. Hope.